Hi everyone, Dave from BBVs here. Just thought I'd give you a quick little tutorial on how to resize an application order icon using Composer, how to add a focus icon in Composer, and how to do it in the SVG as well, for those that just want to code it in SVG instead, and how to change your frames per state on buttons in Composer. This basically just makes it all that little bit faster to run. What we're going to use is BlackBerry Composer, and Notepad++ for editing the SVG as well. So if we just jump into Composer and make a new file, we'll call this one button resizing. Now in here, you'll see you've got your objects panel and your inspector panel. Go into Windows, and to get those up, all you do is you just hit inspector and objects and make sure that they're both ticked. You can also use Control 4 and Control 6 as your shortcuts for this as well. So with those panels there, just select the theme button from the left hand side and place it on your canvas. And we want to make it device application order so the user can set it as they want. Now, as a standard for the device that we've chosen here, we've got 80 by 80 pixels for the icon size, but this differs for whichever device that you're making it for. Make sure that your icon is selected. If you've got multiple icons, like you probably will have, make sure that you've got the right one selected in your objects panel, and just select edit in the top left. This then allows you to edit the image really easily. You've got your focus and normal state images here for your button. Do the focus one first, just click on top. So in your change bitmap, here you can change the actual image of that button. What we're going to do is we're going to replace it with a 52 by 52, just for this tutorial. You can replace it with any size as long as it's a square one. And we can do the normal image as well. And we'll replace that one with the normal one, not the focus one. And again, 52 by 52, just got to be both the same size. Now on the bottom we have your four states across here. You've got your initial state, so when a device boots up, your focus in state, your focus out state, and your activate, so when you click to select your icon or whatever function the button performs. Now with these states, they're all currently 10 frames long, but because we've not got any animation at all for the button itself, you know, we don't want it spinning or moving or anything on focusing or anything like that. You can just drop the default down to 2. And what this will do is this will just make it that little bit more faster to run. It reduces the lag a little bit as well. And what you do tend to find is a slight difference in file size as well. So if you've got a big theme, you're going to notice it a little bit more in the file size side of everything as well. When they're all done, make sure that they're on 2. You can't have them set to 1, and if you do, it will give you an error when you import it into Composer, into Theme Builder, sorry. And then the real problem that you have then is if you've got a lot of buttons, you have to go through every single one just to check which one it is. So it can take a little while, so always check when you've changed them over. Now you hit the Scene button, go back to where you were with your canvas here, and there we have your theme button 1, and as you can see it's smaller, and it's the 52 by 52 pixels there. This now means that the user can set it to smaller image, and you'll still get your image notification icon on there for definitely for OS 5. You can find on some devices on lower OSs it can play up a little bit, so test it out before you put it in a theme. Now what other people have been asking for as well is a focus icon for the background. So we'll just make a rectangle that you can import using the file and import, and you can import your own image into there as well. When you make your rectangle, obviously it's going to throw it up here into your objects, and you can see it's actually made it on top of the button. Now we don't want that because we want to be able to see our button. So you can just grab it and just pull it behind. And there you can see our button and our focus image as well. As it's just an image at the moment, we can't really do too much with it. So what we need to do is just right click and convert it to an animation. And in this part, in the inspector panel, we can just rename it. So we're going to rename it to match the button. So we're going to rename it focus 1. And by matching it with the button, it makes it a lot easier when you come to either coding it or making it show and hide, like what I'm showing now. It's having a match up. If you've got multiple buttons, it's a lot easier. So select the button. And you see you have new events. You have one activate event, which is to launch the actual program itself that the button relates to. And then currently nothing happening for focus in and focus out. So click on focus in. You'll see there the on activate launched application. We want to show a component, and we want to show on focus in and focus 1, which is this animation that we've just made. And if it's not focus 1 that you want, you can select your object from this drop down, and it specifically relates to the items in your objects panel by here. Now, what I was saying about numbering them correctly is that there we have focus 1 for theme button 1. Say you're on button 10, that's going to be a long way down the list, and if it's a completely different number to what matches, unless you've got them written down, you know, you could easily get them confused, and you only find out when you've actually got it either on the device or in the simulator whether it's actually all working and hiding and showing the correct ones. So that little bit of prep work does make it a lot easier at the beginning. So now that we've got it showing on focus in, we want to hide it. Double click there. And want to hide focus 1. Again, it's just selected it automatically from there because it's the top one, but you can select whichever image it is. And currently it's saying on focus in because it picks up the last state. So we'll change that in the event type to focus out. Now that that's done, you have show focus 1 on focus in, hide focus 1 on focus out, which is exactly what we want. And the only thing that we need to do now is just make sure that we can have this this image, this animation, our focus icon, hidden when the theme starts up, because otherwise the user's going to have to scroll through all the buttons to hide the images, which a lot of people say, you know, it's not ideal. So it's a really simple one to get around. Going to interactivity and actions. And if you see all of the actions, so you'll see, for example, the three that we've set here, your button, your show, and your hide, your focus icon. But for every single button, animation, absolutely everything shows in here for the entire composer file. So we want to hide. And we want to hide, again, just select whichever one it is that you want from here, from your objects again. And we want to hide focus 1 and at frame 1. That's basically just the beginning, so on startup of the actual device. So now with that done, when the screen turns on, that focus image will be hidden. So now all you need to do is just export it as an SVG, and you're done. You can load it into your theme builder, and away you go. So here we are in Notepad++. Really simple, really nice and easy to use text editor, completely free to download, and it's got really helpful tools, like you've got your tabs so you can flip between different projects, your line numbers so you can see where everything is, and also the search functionality is brilliant on it as well. Anyway, that said, basically this top line here is the information that you need to hide an animation or button or any particular asset when you're on theme startup. So to go through here, you've got your focus 1, which is the animation that we made. Then you set display to none, so basically it's hidden, and begin at 0. So 0 is that frame 1 that we saw in Composer. And then this next pair of lines here, we've got animation focus 1, And we've got that set to display to inline. So yes to display this, basically. And that's this action on theme button 1, focus in. Basically, when you focus in theme button 1, that animation should be displayed. And then you then have the hiding factor on the line below. So your animation focus 1, set display to none, so hidden again. And that's on theme button 1, focus out. And the really good thing about this, as I said, is if you number them all up correctly, you can literally copy and paste it through, change the numbers, and it all works absolutely perfectly for you.